Hello friends. Welcome to the channel. Today we will see the measurement of earth resistance and why earth resistance measurement is important. We generally see this type of structure near houses, buildings, or factories. And at electrical substations, these structures are in quite a large numbers. This is an earthing structure. Its shape and size vary as per the use. Now let's see, how do we measure earth resistance? We will take the example of earthing pipes in an electrical substation. We know that electrical substations have earthing mesh, also called grounding mesh, earthing grid, or earth mat, which is buried underground. This earthing mesh is made of interconnected MS flats, which are mild steel flats. This earthing mesh is connected to earthing pipe. These earthing pipes are buried deeper as compared to earthing mesh. Let's measure the earth resistance of this pipe using this earth resistance tester. After charging the tester sufficiently, the connections are done. The terminals E1 and P1 are shorted and connected to the earthing pipe, of which resistance is to be measured. Two electrodes are buried in the earth at a distance of 20 meters from each other in the pipe, of which resistance is to be measured. Then terminal P2 is connected to one electrode and terminal E2 is connected to another electrode. Now suitable range on the tester is selected and the test button is pressed. Then the reading appears on the screen. This is how the resistance of each earthing pipe is measured. This is a very important test as it indicates how solid and effective pipe earthing is, which subsequently indicates the healthiness of the overall substation earthing system. Also, proper grounding or earthing at the substation is very crucial as it provides the path for fault current, which otherwise would have damaged the electrical equipment. So guys, this is about earth resistance measurement. Hope you liked the video. If yes, please hit the like button. For more videos, please subscribe. Thank you.